Hey Europa, welcome to a new video on my channel, and in this video is everything about the Melodifestivalen that will take place on Saturday. And yeah, I will react to all 12 finalists, or I won't react, but I will give my opinion on them because I listened to the songs in the shows, because I watched all 5 shows, and this would take too long to listen to all the songs right now. But what I do is react and give my opinion, and or just give my opinion. I don't react, but I give my opinion, and yeah, also my favorites in the end. But first, let's react in the running order. And first is, well, I always say react, but you know what I mean. It is so in my DNA, this word right now. But yeah, I will, yeah, give my opinion on the songs, and starting with the running order. Or doing it in the running order. What happened with me? I can't talk, oh my god. But okay, I do it in the running order. And first is Jon Henrik Fjällgren and his song No Skin. And this is his song. It's really something different and something, it's Joik music, and he tried it twice before, in 2015 finishing second and 2017 in the third place. And this time I really really think that his song is good enough. It is really a mix of Joik music but also pop music, radio friendly music, and it's really really positive and happy, and also really emotional in my opinion. I can really feel it, and I think that the performance is really really good. And it's maybe a bad thing that he opens the show. This will kill everything, sadly. So this is one of my favorites, but I have many favorites, so maybe I'm not allowed to call so many artists and songs my favorites, but this is, I really really enjoy it. It's in my playlist everywhere, and yeah, pray for him that he will get a good place. And yeah, next on the list is Lisa Ajax with her song Torn, and this is her song. I am torn, I am torn, build me up, little light, 'cause you broke me to pieces. You broke me to pieces. Really emotional. I never thought that she will bring a song like this to Melodifestivalen. She made it over under constant to the final, and I was a little bit surprised that she didn't made it directly, but yeah, now it's over under constant and it is also good. And I am not sure, it's of course a good song, but it is in the chorus, sometimes I feel that she scream a little bit. Maybe it's okay, maybe not. But I don't like it when they are screaming. But it's just my taste, and it is a really, really good song. And there's also Victoria in the race, also ballad, little spoiler. And I think that these two ballads will battle, and one of them will finish really high and come and will battle for the victory, and the other one will end really like 10th place or something like this, so at the bottom. But yeah, I think that Lisa Ajax and Torn, this is the worst one, but it is also really really strong. And yeah, hopefully she'll get a good place, and I really really enjoyed it. So that's my opinion on Torn and Lisa Ajax. So the third artist is Mohombi, and his song is called Hello, and yeah, that's Hello.
Hello, 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 hello.
really, really, again, as Sweden always, I don't have to say this because all are really radio friendly. This is a little bit too, I don't know if old school is the right word, but it reminds me of a song from like 2011. And that's not a good thing, and it's everything from the style is really, really too much mainstream. And yeah, but it is really good, and Mohombi is a good artist, but this song is just too standard and too flat and won't make it good at Eurovision. He won't make it to Eurovision in general, but if he would be the representative for Sweden at Eurovision, then Sweden wouldn't have a good place. So, and I want that they will have a good place, so don't set him. And this song, just because it is too flat and too mainstream. So that's my opinion on Mohombi. Let's go to the fourth artist. It's Lida Hedlund and the song Victorious. We have a chance to take it far. Don't forget how to be us. Oh, we gotta be strong. Like Jessica Andersson last year with her song Party Voice. This time it's better than Party Voice. I really, really enjoyed it more. I don't know why. Maybe because I was annoyed from Party Voice last year really, really early, and Victorious, it's like an anthem and I want more about this, and I'm a little bit addicted to this. This is really, really strong and really, really up-tempo, happy, and I think the arena will be really, really, yeah, I don't know how to say, but they will celebrate her in the arena, but she won't win. But maybe she will get a place in the top 7, I really hope, and yeah, hopefully. So let's go to the next artist, is Bishara and the song On My Own. I can't get by on my own. See, I can make it without you. Don't let go. See, I can wake up all alone in my bed. Look to Teeny Pop from Sweden. He is only 15 years old, so just like me, maybe like months later, because I wouldn't be allowed to go to Eurovision because I won't get 16 before May, but yeah, that's another thing. This song is just a no for me because it is, his voice is way too high in my opinion, and the song is just, I don't know how to say, but it's really, really flat and like nothing. It is one of the songs that will, maybe the Taylor Road will put him higher than Shuri Rhodes, but he won't be really successful, and hopefully he won't. So yeah, that's my opinion on Bishara. Next artist is Anna Bay and Dawn and Ashes to Ashes. Well, just watch me as you. Yeah, that's also a song from Anna Kansen, and I don't know why everyone is hyping this song. I love it too, but not that much. I saw her as the winner from Anna Kansen, but not that it could go to Eurovision. It's just not that good for Sweden to go to Eurovision, to remember. And then my voice is gone. Oh no. But yeah, it isn't that good for going to Eurovision for Sweden, in my opinion. It's really, really radio friendly, like also really country vibes in it, and I really enjoy this, but it's like not old but also not really from 2019 radio song, but it's nothing against it, it's just not the song that I would choose for Eurovision, and send it to Tel Aviv, but that's just my opinion, and it's a good song, but yeah, maybe she'll make it to the top 5. And the next act is Nano. Oh, forgot the song, it's Chasing Mirrors, and yeah, I love it so much. It is like his last Melodifestivalen entry, Hold On, but I don't care. It is extremely good, and I first was a little bit confused if this song could do well, but now I'm sure that it could really do well. Others are saying no, but this is really good, and I think the juries could rank this high, but the televote won't, so yeah. This song is really R&B kind of, and it could really do well with the jury voting. The televoting won't vote for him, but yeah, it's also radio friendly as always, and Nano has an extremely good voice, and the performance is really good, and staging, everything is perfect, so I really enjoyed it, and it is one of my favorites. I know it isn't a favorite, but it is one of my favorites, so yeah, and that's everything what I have to say about Nano. Let's go to the next act. It's Hannah Pham and Liamo with the song Hold You. I love this. I first wasn't sure about it because it reminded me of something, but of another song, but it is also really radio friendly, chart friendly. Okay, I'll stop saying this because all songs are in this kind, but yeah, this song is so good. It is really emotional also from Hannah and also Liamo, and yeah, the staging is, it looks brilliant on stage, and the song is amazing, and I can't get enough of this song. I first wasn't sure, but now I love it, and how much more I listen to this, I enjoy it more, and I hope it will continue, and it is one of my absolutely favorites this year, and it could even win. It could even win, and at Eurovision it could also made it to the top 5 because it is the really strong year, but not only because of this. It's a song that could be really loved from the juries and televoting, and yeah, I think that this could be played in radios and also win Eurovision 2019, but that's just my opinion, and yeah, so I don't know if it will win, it could, but there are also other really strong entries. So let's continue with the act number 8, Melody number 8. It is, no, Otta, Melody number 8, it's Malu Brütz and the song I Do Me. Work it out, you want to come to see, someone just gonna shout. Surprise that she made it to the final, but it is a good song. I really enjoyed it. The staging is something different, but also good. But I think that this is one of the worst songs on the final, but it is really good. It has quality. And yeah, but I think you won't remember this song really much. Yeah, it is my 11th place right now. And yeah, so don't hate me, but this is just my opinion. Next act is Jon Unvik and Too Late for Love. Make it burn for you and me. If I could be there, I would be there. Hear me, I could be the sun that lights your dark. This is the big favorite, really, really big, and there's a really big hype, like the last big hypes on this level were on Mont Saint-Maloof and on Loreen, and they won, and they also won Eurovision, and now it's everything about Jon Lundvik, and he is extremely sympathetic, and I really enjoy his gospel parts. It sounds a little bit like Austria, but only because of the genre, and yeah, but I really enjoy the gospel part and his voice is emotional. I also loved My Turn from last year, and this song is the song that could really win Eurovision 2019. I think if Sweden will choose him, that it will be my number one. End of discussion, this will be my number one if Sweden will choose Jon Lundvik, and yeah, it's so incredibly good. And the next act is also really incredibly good. It's Victoria and Not With Me. Gave you my heart. Can't believe you just tore it apart. They keep telling me, girl, you'll be fine. But how can that be when you're not with me? Trying to forget, but who's gonna sleep? Wow, I got goosebumps during this song, and I usually don't get goosebumps really often, but this really touched me, and the performance, this showers, I say, or the rain, was so, so perfect, and her voice so emotional and good, and I really felt everything when I saw it live in the Melodifestivalen at Erlinget. So now it is my number one or two or three, one of these places, and yeah, this will finish high and will also finish high Eurovision if it will be chosen. What is with my voice and my body? I don't know. But yeah, this will be really, really good at Eurovision if they will choose her, and yeah, I predict a really, really strong place for her. And now the last place, the big surprise that they made it to the final. Maybe they aren't a big surprise, but for me, it wasn't clear that they are in the final. It's Armin Gunnar and the song I Do. First I Do Me, now I Do, and I don't know why, but I enjoyed it a little bit. It sounds like an oldie, and it is really, really good. The old boy group that wants to know it once again, and Eloise was a classic song, extremely, really good. Okay, not classic, but you know what I mean. It is extremely good, and this song is also not bad, but it isn't just... I think everyone knows it, that they won't finish really high, and they will end up in the last place, I think it too, but I really, 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 really like this song, and I would be happy, and they would deserve it to be not last place, but I think it will happen. The Swedish voters, the public will vote them maybe high, but yeah, maybe not. So that's my opinion on the songs, and now let's talk about my favorites, and I have four favorites. The first favorite is Victoria. She is so, so emotional and so, so good from her vocals, and It really touched my heart, as I said, and yeah, I think this could really finish high. The second favorite, in my opinion, is Liamo and Hanafem. And yeah, Hold Me is such a big earworm, and it is so, so, yeah, memorable from the performance, and this will finish really high at Melodifestivalen and at Eurovision. It could win. And the third favorite is Jon Henrik Fjällgren, or Joik Henrik Fjällgren, like I say really often, because it's Joik music, and it is the best Joik singer ever. Sorry, Kaino fans, but this is better. Jon Henrik Fjällgren is better than Kaino. I didn't say that it's better than that Noskian is better than Spirit in the Sky, but I said that Jon Henrik is better than Kaino. Yeah, this song is also pretty, pretty good, and it is one of my favorites. It used to be my number one, but now it is... I don't want to say that it isn't my number one, because I have so many number ones, but yeah, it isn't my only number one right now. And yeah, my fourth favorite, and I think that he will win Melodifestivalen and also Eurovision maybe, is Jon Lundvik and Too Late for Love. This, just everything is perfect. The gospel is perfect, his voice is perfect, everything is also emotional and radio friendly and so positive. I always have to smile and laugh when I listen to this song, and especially to the chorus, and I have so much energy during listening to this, and I hope Sweden will choose him and Europe will choose Sweden. Once again, I'm so sorry, but I hope that they will win with Jon Lundvik, and yeah, that's would be maybe my choice, Jon Lundvik with Too Late for Love. And yeah, that's my opinion on the songs. And what do you think about Melodifestivalen? Yeah, write in the comments and subscribe to my channel, would be really, really good. Like this video if you want, and yeah, hopefully we are one opinion, but I don't know, what do you think? So yeah, see you in the next video, have a good day, and bye.